Hello, explorers, and welcome to Alaska, the last frontier. Today, we're taking you on a journey to see the best places to visit in Alaska. From its snow-capped peaks to its majestic calving glaciers, we're setting off on a journey to explore the top destinations that this vast, beautiful state has to offer. Are you ready to check out the best places to visit in Alaska with us? Let's get started. Next up is Glacier Bay National Park. Glacier Bay is the number one stop on any Alaskan cruise. And while on a cruise, you will circle within the bay witnessing the majesty of tidewater glaciers. We're spending about an hour circling here on Glacier Bay, and having a veranda room is amazing because I'm just sitting here watching the Marjorie Glacier calve and everything go by from the comfort of my very own private balcony. Very lucky. While in Glacier Bay, keep your eyes peeled for humpback whales breaching, seals sunning on ice floes, orcas prowling the depths, and sea otters playfully floating on their backs. They are the cutest. We've seen all of these during our three separate cruises to Alaska.
Amazing.
Wow, that's pretty amazing. The Marjorie Glacier behind me just calved right while we were filming. Imagine that.
This dramatic display known as calving is a sight you won't forget, and we've had the luxury of seeing them a few times.
Oh my god!
Crazy!
We're just gonna coast right up and over with them.
Wow, that was pretty amazing. We're now riding the waves of a calving glacier. Wow.
We're going on a skiff tour to explore the glacier. Another major stop for cruises is the Endicott Arm that snakes through the Tracy Arm Fjord Wilderness area. And when visiting this incredible body of water, you must book a Zodiac tour to Dawes Glacier.
Well, we are having an amazing day just booting around Dawes Glacier here with amazing deep blue icebergs and great people on the skiff with us. And we're just having a blast. What do you think, Dave?
Wish you were here. At least I bet you do.
Next up is Denali National Park, the third largest national park in America and home to the highest peak in North America.
Welcome to Denali.
Mount Denali stands guard at over 20,000 feet. And the best way to see it is by taking a scenic flight. Flights over Denali begin at about $250 per person.
This can be one of the more expensive excursions, but this is a bucket list trip after all, so it's worth it.
There are plenty of excursions to take in Denali, and we also took an ATV tour, which is a great way to explore the backcountry. Horseback riding is another great option to take in the extraordinary scenery in Denali. Both tours start at about $120 to $140 per person for 1 hour, and they go up from there. But the most popular, affordable, and easiest way to see Denali is to take a narrated bus tour through the National Park Service.
So the only way into Denali National Park is on the school buses. You can come in about 20 miles to do some camping. Other than that, there's no motorized vehicles except for these buses. Everyone else has to be on bicycles or come in and do some hiking. So it's pretty cool because it keeps the traffic down when you think about it. This is one of the most visited parks in the United States.
The Tundra Wilderness Tour is a 5.5 hour tour taking you deep within the park to mile 43.
Well, right behind me is Denali, and we are so lucky because only 30% of the people who come to Denali actually see it. And we are having a crystal clear day today. Let's hope the wildlife watching is just as good.
Denali is one of the best places in Alaska to spot doll sheep, caribou, and brown bears in their natural habitat. And the bus drivers do an excellent job spotting them because they're quite difficult to find with the naked eye. Next up, we take you to Fairbanks, also known as the Golden Heart City. Fairbanks is located less than 200 miles south of the Arctic Circle,
With its unique location, it offers the chance to experience the midnight sun in the summer and the northern lights in the winter. If you book a cruise in late August or September, you have a great chance of catching this dazzling display. For excursions, you can do everything from taking a riverboat cruise to visiting the Alaska Pipeline and learning about its gold mining history.
This interactive tour took us by train to Gold Dredge Number 8 to see the process of mining and panning for gold before trying it ourselves.
Not bad. Don't have a career in panning for gold, I gotta say.
The Riverboat Discovery Tour is a three-hour tour from Fairbanks that goes to an Athabascan village where you learn about salmon harvesting, storing, and preparations. And you'll see the dog kennels of the late Iditarod legend and winner, Susan Butcher. From the comfort of your historic riverboat, you'll also watch a bush pilot demonstration. This is one of the most popular tours in Fairbanks, so make sure you book it well in advance. One of the main tourist attractions in Juneau, Alaska is the enormous Mendenhall Glacier located on the Juneau Ice Field. This is one of the most accessible glaciers in Alaska and it is not to be missed. There are several excursions to Mendenhall Glacier, from paddling in a canoe to hiking directly to Nugget Falls. You can get right beside the glacier and there are specific tours that you can book to see the Mendenhall Ice Caves.
We're heading out to Neats Bay to watch some black bears hopefully feed on some salmon today. We're taking a float plane out and are we ever lucky? It's a beautiful day, clear skies, so it's a go.
Welcome to bear watching.
Ketchikan is known as the salmon capital of the world, and one of the best things to do in Ketchikan is to see black bears feeding on spawning salmon. The best time to see the bears feeding is between July and September.
So what makes this bear tour so special is that it's at a salmon hatchery. So the salmon come spawning up the river and the bears are just like, you know, it's just a smorgasbord, it's a feast.
Watching from a safe distance from within our hides, we witnessed a half a dozen bears come and go during our 90 minutes on the island.
Now that was amazing. Getting up so close to those black bears, incredible.
There are many places to see bears in the wild in Alaska, from Mendenhall Glacier to Denali, and chances are if you're on a cruise or land tour, you will see them. If you want to see brown bears feeding on salmon, Katmai National Park and Preserve and Kodiak National Wildlife Refuge are two great places to go.
Next on our journey is South Marble Island. This place is known for its birds, especially puffins, and whales. Oh my.
South Marble Island has a feel of a mini Galapagos Islands with a variety of seabirds like cormorants, kittiwaks, and puffins. It has some of the best birdwatching in Alaska, but you'll also see plenty of harbor seals, stellar sea lions, and otters. It was near this island that we had our best whale watching experience ever in the entire state of Alaska. Well, when there's a good fluke, the whole crowd is excited, and that was a good fluke, ladies and gentlemen.
We're all suited up and ready to go kayaking here on George Island in Alaska. Let's go.
If you book a small ship tour with someone like Uncruise, you will have plenty of opportunities to go kayaking. We have a complete guide on our time with Uncruise in the links below, but if you want to do some paddling on your Alaskan cruise, there are plenty of excursions in Ketchikan, Skagway, and Juneau starting at around $150 per person.
All right, we're in our double kayak here and we're ready to take a beautiful day of kayaking here on George Island. Hi, Deb.
Hi, Dave.
As
many of you probably already know, Dave and I just love kayaking to explore the wilderness when we're traveling. Really, there's nothing else like it. And I think that the polar regions in Alaska, it's the place to do it because it's just filled with wildlife. We have landed at Bartlett Cove, and it is a really historic place here in the park. The Tlingit people have made a longhouse, a traditional longhouse, that they reopened on the 100th anniversary of the national parks here in the United States. And this is all about starting the healing relationship between the Tlingit people and the national parks. Because as we know, the native people of North America were treated very poorly, but now it is starting to heal the relationships now. And this is a great start.
Ketchikan has the world's largest collection of standing totem poles, and a great way to learn about them is to visit the Totem Heritage Center, which houses an extensive collection of totem poles from all of the Alaskan cultures. Also, make your way to the Saxum Native Village to see more totem poles and an authentic clan house.
Creek Street runs along the Ketchikan Creek, and there are plenty of shops, restaurants, and historical buildings to explore. The boardwalk was once the city's red light district, but today it's made for tourists to enjoy its colorful buildings and beautiful views of the creek.
Our next stop was Skagway, which is the gateway to the Yukon and heart of the Klondike Gold Rush. Downtown Skagway is a national historic park dedicated to the Klondike Gold Rush. There are more than 100 historic buildings and structures featuring exhibits, films, and interactive displays that explore the history and culture of the region.
Skagway is also the gateway to the Chilkoot Trail, and you can book hikes to take a portion of this historic route used by prospectors in the 1800s.
One of the most popular attractions of this Gold Rush town is the White Pass Railway.
All aboard the White Pass Railway.
This historic narrow gauge railway was built in 1897 and takes you up to the summit of White Pass into Canada's Yukon Territories. It is considered one of the great train rides in the world.
Misty Fjords National Monument is located 22 miles east of Ketchikan. The best way to take in this natural wonder is by float plane to witness its sea cliffs, steep fjords, and rock walls jutting 3,000 feet straight out of the ocean. Misty Fjords has constant precipitation with 150 inches of annual rainfall, creating a massive thick forest offering endless views of lush green vegetation. Located within the Tongass National Forest, you will be able to see two natural wonders in one trip. The Tongass National Forest is the largest functioning temperate rainforest on Earth. The size of the Tongass National Forest is mind-blowing at more than 16 million acres of land stretching from Ketchikan to Juneau. Besides flights, you can go hiking, kayaking, wildlife viewing, and see its beautiful glaciers. Our final destination is Anchorage, Alaska's largest city.
Make sure you take a walk on the Anchorage Historic Route here in Anchorage, Alaska.
Anchorage is an easy city to take a self-guided walking tour, or you can hop on the trolley. You can book tours that will take you out to the Turnagain Arm, or you can book some boat tours to explore the fjords and glaciers and the wildlife of the area. Many cruises begin in Anchorage, and our Holland America cruise took us aboard the cruise train to Whittier, where we saw many of the top attractions en route to our embarkation point.
We're on the train to Whittier.
Yeah, actually we're going through one of the tunnels right now.
We have two total. And then we are there.
Yeah? Yeah, then we start the cruise part.
Woohoo!
To watch what it's like on an Alaskan cruise, click on the links below. We have an entire video dedicated to what you can expect on an Alaskan cruise on the New Amsterdam. And these are the best places to visit in Alaska. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to subscribe to our channel and click on that bell so that you get notifications, because we appreciate you watching each week and we don't want you to miss a thing.